Io, one hell of a moon. Volcanoes are a unique feature of our Earth. Our Earth is relatively new as compared to other solid worlds in our solar system. Some worlds have a few volcanic activities and some worlds lack any volcanic activity. But there is one strange place in our solar system which outclasses everything else in terms of volcanic activity. Galileo discovered four massive moons around our largest planet, Jupiter, using a telescope in 1610. Callisto was the farthest out, followed inward by Ganymede, Europa, and lastly, the closest world, Io. While Callisto and Ganymede are enormous and extensively cratered, and Europa appears to be covered in ice, when we take a good close look at Io, it appears to be vastly different from the other worlds. What's so special about Io that makes it stand out in our solar system? We are about to find out in this video. While the Earth's crust is the smallest of its layers, it is neither homogeneous nor distinctive. The Earth's crust is thinnest and simplest to penetrate, where the deeper mantle is packed thickest beneath it. In contrast, if the mantle does not begin until it reaches its greatest subterranean depths, the crust accumulates the most. The crust-mantle border is where many events and interactions, including plate tectonics, lead the rocks beneath the Earth's surface to melt. Magma chambers form as a result of this. Because our planet's surface area to mass ratio is minimal, as it is for all huge rocky worlds, that energy has a difficult time escaping, building up, then releasing irregularly in catastrophic events such as volcanoes and earthquakes. You're probably familiar with ice melting, and you've probably noticed that ice floats over water because it's less dense in its solid phase than it is in its liquid phase. Water is a fairly uncommon element in this regard, accounting for anything from icebergs in the ocean to ice cubes in your summer drinks. The liquid phase of most materials, including rocks, is less dense than the solid phase, and this means that when magma forms beneath the surface, it both expands, shattering and displacing the rocks on either side, and strives to rise due to its reduced density and buoyancy. When enough magma creates enough pressure, a volcanic eruption occurs, which occurs numerous times every year at various locations around the Earth's surface. However, this is not the case on most rocky planets. In terms of solid worlds, the Earth's crust is rather young. Compare the Earth's surface to that of Mercury or the Moon, where craters have existed for billions of years, untouched and unpolluted by volcanic activity. While the Earth is rife with volcanic eruptions, magma vents, and consistent eruptions, these small, geologically inactive, at least relatively inactive, worlds haven't had a good resurfacing since the solar system's inception. Volcanoes do occur on worlds you might not expect, such as Jupiter's tiny moon Io. Io appears to be an odd choice for volcanoes, with only 1.5% of Earth's mass, but having more than a quarter of the Earth's diameter, as 4.5 billion years is more than enough time for it to have cooled and become stable. However, Io is far from stable, since a slew of volcanic eruptions were anticipated before we even had a good look at it. When the Voyager 1 spacecraft visited Io, it discovered hundreds of volcanic calderas, including genuine eruptions with plumes 300 kilometers high. Following that, observations from Voyager 2, Galileo, and a slew of telescopes revealed that these eruptions alter fast on Io's surface. While Callisto and Ganymede are enormous and extensively cratered, and Europa appears to be covered in ice, when we take a good close look at Io, it appears to be vastly different from the other worlds. To be sure, it's covered with rock and has a pockmarked face, a little like an adolescent who can't stop scratching. However, there is one feature of Io that distinguishes it from the other stony worlds we've discovered. There are no craters. As we've learned, there's a good reason for this. And if you thought Earth's tides were bad, you haven't seen anything until you've seen Io's. But have you noticed Io's two bright spots? Those are active volcanoes, which are currently erupting. If you're used to seeing volcanoes on Earth, you could assume this is a once-in-a-lifetime occurrence that we just happened to witness. After all, if they can light up the world's surface like this, these must be rather stunning eruptions, and there are two of them going on at the same time. However, a deeper examination, or rather persistent examinations of Io, reveals that these eruptions are extremely prevalent. Io's surface is the most recent in the solar system. Why don't there appear to be any craters on its surface? On timescales of thousands to tens of thousands of years, these eruptions cover the entire globe in a fresh coat of lava, which hardens into rock. What is causing this? The answer is straightforward. Jupiter, which works as a cosmic Zamboni on Io, creating resurfacing and surface lava as if it had nothing else to do in the universe. All of this energy is because of the combined tidal forces of Jupiter and the outer Jovian moons. On Earth, gravity from the sun and moon causes ocean tides to rise and fall by 1 to 2 meters on average, which is far too little to create significant heating. Despite the fact that Io lacks oceans, the tidal forces acting on it cause the world to stretch and bend by an astounding 100 meters at a time. This not only causes cracking and fissures, but also heats up the planet's interior, similar to how rapidly bending a piece of metal back and forth causes it to heat up internally. When a path to the surface opens up, that internal heat escapes through quiescent lava flows and catastrophic volcanic eruptions. The hottest points on Io's surface reach 1200 degrees Celsius, or 2000 degrees Fahrenheit, in comparison to the average surface temperature of 110 Kelvin, minus 163 degrees Celsius, or minus 261 degrees Fahrenheit. Io has the most dramatic temperature changes across locations outside of the sun. The combined effects of the moon and sun on Earth generate minor tides, raising and lowering the oceans by 1 meter at a time, and causing the crust to swell and shrink by millimeters or centimeters with each rotation. But on Io, the tidal forces caused by Jupiter are enormous, 10,000 times stronger than what we experience here on Earth. And this is significant enough to rend the surface of Io apart with almost every orbit of the moon around its shepherding planet. While our tides cause the oceans to rise and fall, Jupiter's tides create magma just beneath Io's surface, then rip that surface apart, allowing it to rise to the crust in a constant state of eruption. If our moon were 20 times closer to Earth than it is now, the tidal forces on our planet would have the same effect, rendering our planet virtually uninhabitable, as Io does. Fortunately, the moon is at a safe distance, and any resurfacing is caused by Earth's own physics rather than the tidal influence of a cataclysmic outsider. But as Jupiter wreaks havoc on Io, Europa lies just far enough out in what is possibly the sweetest place of all. Io becomes deformed, heats up, and explodes simply by orbiting where it does, making it the most volcanically active world in the entire solar system. Other moons orbiting gas giants have stunning eruptions as well. For example, Enceladus orbiting Saturn. But no world's surface is as molded by volcanic activity as Jupiter's innermost moon, Io. While Jupiter's surface is covered in ice, the heat generated by its tides should be sufficient to support undersea magma vents, a heat source, and a liquid ocean deep beneath the ice. NASA recently announced a mission to Europa to investigate whether the moon contains the ingredients required for chemical-based life. A tantalizing possibility. While this Zamboni-like effect is disastrous for Io, the most active and resurfaced world in the solar system, a light version of it may have been exactly what its neighboring world required to give rise to the most fragile and spectacular combination of atoms we've ever discovered. A self-reproducing, information-encoding, sustaining set of reactions we call life. It's remarkable what a little, or a lot, in a different sense, of push and pull can do. So what do you think about the strangeness of Io? Isn't it one hell of a moon? Let us know what you think in the comment section below. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel.